Welcome to Yun Tuition. I am Yun. I'm so glad to see many comments on my previous talk on Sabine Hossenfelder's misconceptions about free energy and waste heat. Despite that, I only evaluated the first part of her talk. I will make another talk on the rest of her talk, but before that, I would like to discuss the original work Sabine cited in her talk, namely this paper published in Nature in 2022 by Thomas Murphy, a professor in physics from University of California at San Diego. So are you ready? I mean to like, to share, and to subscribe, as well as to make your little bell activated so that you will not miss any of my new talk. Okay, let's go and have fun. The first assumption Tom Murphy made in his paper is that the power, that's to say the total energy in joule generated by humans per second, has been increasing exponentially since the 20th century, which is used in his first equation, where the rate R is estimated to be 0.023 or 2.3%. I will evaluate this assumption at the end of this talk, but I will simply use it now. How did Murphy use this exponentially increasing power to calculate the surface temperature of the Earth? Well, he was obliged to borrow the equation widely used in the greenhouse effect narrative, namely, the current global mean surface temperature is the sum of the surface temperature without greenhouse gases and 33 Kelvin, which is called the greenhouse effect type 1, as shown here. This numerical equation can be denoted in terms of the solar constant S, although he used F in his paper, the planetary albedo alpha, which is 0.293 or close to 0.3, and Tg equal to 33 Kelvin, the temperature increment due to the so-called greenhouse effect, respectively, as shown in his second equation. As I have discussed before, nevertheless, this equation is conceptually wrong. To understand this mistake, let's omit the so-called greenhouse effect term first, and then rewrite the formula algebraically. Then multiply pi r squared on both sides, where r is the radius of the Earth. Notice that pi r squared represents the area of cross-section of the Earth, and 4 pi r squared is the total surface area of the Earth. Because power equal to intensity multiplies area, this equation tells us that after reflection, the effective solar radiation power is equal to the thermal radiation power by a spherical black body. How come? Because the emissivity here is a unit or one. However, this equation is incorrect. Why? Because by definition, the reflectivity of black body should be zero rather than 29%. If we use a gray body to describe the Earth with reflectivity alpha, then its emissivity becomes 1 minus alpha rather than unit. By using 1 minus alpha as the emissivity for this gray body, the surface temperature without any greenhouse gases is TS is closer to 278 Kelvin instead of 255 Kelvin. Which is 10 Kelvin lower than the current surface temperature, 288 Kelvin, rather than 33 Kelvin. Tom Murphy and Sabine Hossenfelder fail to understand how blackbody is defined in physics. The second mistake made by Tom Murphy is more serious. Without any justification, he divided his initial power, P sub zero, by the cross-section area of the Earth, pi r squared. Notice that he causes a small piece of zero as a new quantity in his paper. Perhaps you couldn't find any proper term for it in physics. Oh, wait a moment. Why didn't he call it as, say, proper power, as Einstein used a proper time in his relativity? Can you see my mind is flying? And then he simply added it to the solar radiation contribution, as shown here. In this way, Murphy could make the surface temperature increase with the time t in year. In fact, this is how Thomas Murphy predicted that the surface temperature would reach to the water boiling point in about 400 years from now on. But Murphy's formulation is nonsense. How did I know? His equation implies, or should I say, his equation is equivalent to that. The Earth were illuminated by two stars. One is the sun, and another is an imagined radiation source whose intensity increases exponentially with time. But strangely, he assumed that the Earth could absorb 100% of the radiation emitted by the imagined source without any reflection. Therefore, it seems impossible for anyone to describe his waste heat released by human in this way. If he really needs taking his waste heat into account, sorry, not waste heat, but extra thermal energy to be exact, then he should divide his power, capital P, by the area of the surface of Earth, 4 pi r squared, rather than the Earth's cross-section area seen from the sun, pi r squared. If he did so, then the initial intensity P would be 4 times smaller, 0.1 divided by 4 equal to 0.025 watt per meter squared. As shown in this graph, when this correction is made, the predicted boiling point temperature would be delayed by 60 years if Murphy's model or theory is reasonable. Unfortunately, it is absolutely groundless for Tom Murphy to assume that the waste heat or the total energy either generated or consumed by humans cannot be transported upward and eventually being radiated into outer space. In other words, both conduction and convection cannot selectively pick up the non-wasted thermal energy near the surface. Instead, they indiscriminately pick up anything hotter than required by the surface of the Earth. I have explained several times that the Earth is not incapable of regulating its surface temperature in the event of any internal and external perturbations, including the solar activity, nuclear reactions, and the volcanic eruptions, let alone the so-called waste heat identified by Tom Murphy and Sabine Hossenfelder. Finally, as I promised at the beginning, I would like to point out that the long-term power growth model Thomas Murphy proposed is unrealistic. In general, it is unlikely for any variable in atmospherical or biological systems and the human society to grow exponentially forever. Instead, a logistic function, as used in quantum statistics, is much more realistic and versatile in modeling both naturally occurring and human-created phenomena. As a matter of fact, one can better simulate the trend of the total energy consumed by humans using a logistic function as shown here. Based on the same reported data that Tom Murphy used to build his exponential model for the power, it is demonstrated in this decimal file that a simple logistic function is much more realistic. By way of contrast, Tom Murphy's exponential model is not as good as the logistic model as shown in this picture. How could a logistic model is more realistic than his exponential model. Simple. 1. Human population does not increase exponentially, as shown in this UN projection, in the same year when Murphy's paper was published in Nature. How could he do that, I wonder? 2. The efficiency for manufacturing and running machines have been continuously increasing. Therefore, the cost of raising living standards for developing countries will be much lower than what had been in the developed country in the past to reach that kind of standard. Aha, based on my intuition, I googled a diagram in a recent paper written by many specialists, as shown here. As you can see, my speculation is by no means groundless. I hope Professor Murphy could consider my logistical model for the human total power consumption seriously. To summarize briefly, the two basic equations used by Thomas Murphy in his paper published in Nature in 2022 are physically incorrect. Hence, his prediction that the Earth's surface temperature would be 100 degrees Celsius in less than 400 years is unreliable and misleading and should be rejected. Thank you for watching. Thank you for donation. See you next time.